biocompatibility. Therefore, it is important that many types of conductive elements such as PPY, PANI, PTH, and polyethylene alanine, or PEI, and polyethylene have been shown to support the growth of a large variety of cell types. Additionally, the biocompatibility of polymers is sufficient, easily be improved through bonding biocompatible molecules, segments and side chains onto the polymers, functionalization for a specific application, optimizing the material properties such as roughness, corrosivity, hydrophobicity, conductivity, and degradability, conductive polymers, and the bonding of biological molecules can be done through four major chemical ways. Through absorption.
In this method, a solution of the functionalizing agent is placed in contact with the polymer after it has already been synthesized. The biomolecule is physically absorbed due to the static interactions between the polymer matrix and the charge of the molecule. Although the method is in the simplest to carry out, the outcome is sensitive to pH and the biomolecule is prone to leaching out, and it can compromise the conductivity of the polymer. The second is to entrap the molecule inside the polymer. This is achieved by mixing the functionalizing molecule with the monomer of the polymer, the dopant, and the solvent prior to synthesis. The third one is by covalently bonding the molecule to the monomer of the polymer. With this method, the biological molecules will be strongly bound and will not be released, thereby enhancing the long-term stability of the polymer. And the last one is by exploiting the very doping process that renders conductive polymers conductive. This allows the bonding of a wide range of biomolecules as long as they are charged.
Today we are about to discuss about conductive polymers, which are about biodegradability, drug delivery, and electrical stimulation delivered through a conductive scaffold. Since many of the conductive polymers are not biodegradable, they can be synthesized to becoming one. There are many ways for one conductive polymer to become a biodegradable. First is synthesizing the conductive polymer with a biodegradable one itself. Second is modifying the certain conductive polymer to becoming a biodegradable one. And last are the chains of PPY, that small chains of PPY that undergo gradual erosion and renal clearance simply because due to their small size, they can be electrochemically synthesized.
I'll present on part of my group, so-called topic 10, electromechanical effect. So, in biopolymers, we know that polymers can be from plastics or mechanical metals. So, bioactives, they have been ionized by methods in which they have been used in doping of elements. So there are two specific changes in electrically induced voltage charge. The first one is osmotics. It's in between solvents electrically charged. And the second one is on motion in osmotic also. However, most of the people working in the invention of conductive polymers, they mostly deal with biocompatible and inherently biodegradable polymer. So what they do? They create biodegradable about those methods that they get. So about these biopolymers, they mostly use these two mechanisms, mechanical and both genetically to regenerate tissues in genetic engineering. So they found to be biodegradable and biocompatible to have excellent possibility in conductivity. So to summarize this, I will say that the biocompatibility of these polymers has mostly tested have been found to be worthy. For instance, they found in cancer cells, they use this to regenerate or to find out cells in cancer, where they use it to look through the cells. So the greatest advantage of conductive polymers is their vast versatility. It's about being versatile or like being useful in any arm. So our group has been presenting more about biopolymers. So in bio, we know it's with chips or which we use in biomedical things. So the conductive polymer substrate will be compatible and it's biodegradable in order that our environment